Miss Fry, I brought some books. I hope I'm not intruding by being here.
Quite the contrary. It's nice to have the company. A herbarium? Are you collecting flowers for someone?
Only myself. I'm told it's something of a British pastime. Did you know, they all have symbolic meanings?
I had heard something of the sort.
Of course you have. Unfortunately, I have no time to fill the book.
I could collect some samples, if you would accept my help.
I would appreciate that. Thank you, Miss Fry.
The aura of death surrounds thee both.
Get thee behind me!
Alas, these days, stupidity is all too prevalent. You know, I never asked your names when we last met.
I'm Evie Fry, and this is my brother Jacob.
Tell me, do you believe in ghosts?
Not particularly.
Yes.
I'm skeptical myself. Here we are, in the world's most advanced city, yet its citizens are so enthralled to the supernatural, they leave themselves vulnerable to charlatans. Which is why I joined the Ghost Club. The first society in the world to look systematically at the phenomenon. Because truth, like a spirit, must be cajoled before it will reveal itself. Will you join us?
Sounds absolutely ridiculous. Why not?
It does sound intriguing.
Splendid. I have your first case.
There's been some disturbing reports about a series of assaults in Lambeth. People claim they're being attacked by an age-old demon, Springheel Jack. The fiend is no doubt on the prowl as we speak. It's up to you to find him.
Why not? Here goes.
Here goes. What did we just touch?
Oh, for you. This is it, mates.
I've always got time for you.
Away by some passers-by. Somebody has to do something before he attacks another.
Looks like he ran this way. Perhaps the legend is true and he does have giant claws. Like he ran this way. Heavily guarded warehouse. I wonder what they're heavily guarding.
You seem tired, friend. Everything all right?
There's always too much work to do.
Today's Ghost Club investigation involves a carriage. It's said to be covered with gold leaf, dazzling passers-by when the sun shines. Naturally, it's rumored to be haunted. Now let's see if we can find it.
Oh, I'd rather enjoy a sit-down. But duty calls. The Royal Mail coaches vanished when the post began to be transported by rail. That's curious.
Come on! Movement!
Yes, you're safe. You don't have to worry anymore.
Oh, you've saved me! That wretch would have forced me to marry him within the hour. I must return home. Someone you don't even know. What is your name?
Evie Fry. Faster!
Go on.
And saved my life. I am Elizabeth. Won't you climb down and sit beside me so that I might see your face?
Where is she?
You look as though you're just about to collapse. What on earth has happened?
Just a dream. Or so I think.
There's been a spate of rather intriguing thefts about town recently.
Robberies in London are hardly supernatural events.
They look like common robberies at first, but these perpetrators have all claimed to have been under the influence of some supernatural power. I'm not so foolish as to forget that criminals will spin any yarn to avoid the law. However, these thieves all proffer the same defense. They say they were being controlled by a demon. Will you make some inquiries? One of our demon-possessed mobsmen is being held behind bars at this very moment. You may want to begin your search there.
What's that man done?
Robbed the pawnbrokers down the road.
A demon made me do it. I can't remember much. That's what's so queer. I've never stolen anything in my life before.
Let's pretend that I believe you.
Tell me who made you do it.
All I can recall is a silver watch, swinging in midair. It was held by someone or something. A dark presence whispering. I could only see its eyes. A demon.
I'll need to verify this with the shopkeeper.
Come on, you silly mare.
What can you tell me about the robbery?
There's not much to say. Most of the items did come from the same seller, Enzio Capelli, Sorcerer Supreme, a famous showman from Italy. Several weeks ago, he was forced to pawn his family heirlooms, debts. I have the address of the last person who redeemed something of his, a lovely pearl necklace. That helpful?
Not again! Stop her! Stop! Somebody stop that thief!
You took something from a pawn shop.
It's all very hazy, but I remember something silver flashing in front of my eyes. Then I heard a sort of bell. Next thing I know, I'm here with you.
My only lead is this mysterious buyer. This chap might lead me to the demon.
Yourself.
At this instant, do you hear me?
Blimey! Is this what we've come to?
Come on, bloody Pegasus! Up ya! Come on! Walk on, stupid nag! Up ya! Come on!
Mr. Enzio Capelli, I presume? So you're responsible for the theft of your own jewels?
You are very much mistaken. Aren't you my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. And now you are so very, very tired, aren't you?
Yes, I'm very, very tired.
Now, you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
My goodness, what foul behavior.
What's going on? Where am I?
You've been arrested for theft. How very intriguing.
I can't remember a jot of it.
Let's get you out of here. I've pulled a few strings, and they won't prosecute on account of your losing your mind. Be free, little chicken.